Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain MTI radar system in great details. Here I'll cover basics of MTI radar. After that, I'll explain MTI radar with power amplifier. And at last, I'll explain MTI radar with power oscillator. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of MTI radar system. MTI means moving target indicator. So based on name, you can understand this. It is identifying moving targets only. So MTI radar is used for moving objects. In my last video, I have explained pulsed Doppler radar system. That even we have been using it for moving objects only, right? So here MTI radar, that is also a case of identification of moving objects, right? MTI radar functions based on principle of Doppler effect. With the use of Doppler effect, one can identify motion of the target. Motion means relative velocity. So here we will be using principle of Doppler effect. Based on Doppler effect, there will be deviation in frequency, and based on deviation in frequency, one can identify relative velocity of object. Echo signal from stationary objects are considered as a clutter in MTI radar system. The reason is MTI is used for moving objects only, right? So here from stationary objects, whatever echoes are coming, that is considered as a clutter over here. Basically, there are two types of MTI radar system, and that one can classify based on types of transmitter used in MTI radar. One is there as per MTI radar with power amplifier, and second is there as per MTI radar with power oscillator. So both of these radar system that we are able to study in great detail in this video itself. Let us start with MTI radar with power amplifier. MTI radar with power transmitter has three major elements in its block diagram. First one is antenna. Second is transmitter, and third is receiver. If you talk about antenna, you see here we have single antenna for transmission and reception. Here, as we have single antenna, to isolate high power transmitter and low power receiver, we are using duplexer. This duplexer is transferring high power signal from transmitter to this antenna, and whatever echo that we received by this antenna, that is forwarded to receiver circuit. So basically duplexer, that we use it to isolate high power transmitter and low power receiver circuit. Now, if you talk about transmitter, you see here in transmitter, we have power amplifier. This power amplifier is of klystron amplifier. Here, this power amplifier, that is amplifying input signal. Here input signal to this power amplifier, that is FL plus FC, that is generated by this mixer. So FL plus FC, high frequency RF signal, that is amplified by this power amplifier, that is of klystron amplifier, but that is getting amplified during short duration of pulse as per pulse modulator. So for short duration of time interval, we are generating RF pulse over here with the frequency FL plus FC, right? So for short duration of pulse, this power amplifier is producing high power signal with RF frequency FL plus FC that we are transmitting over here with the use of duplexer via this antenna, right? Now from this antenna, we will be receiving echo from the targets, and here we are delivered to have moving target. So as we are having moving target, received echo signal is having frequency that is FL plus FC plus or minus FD. This plus or minus FD, that is there based on motion of the target. Here, that signal that is getting transferred to receiver over here. See, in receiver, we have two sections, receiver and receiver exciter. Here in the receiver exciter, we have two oscillators, Stello and Coho. This Stello, that is stable local oscillator, and this Coho, that is coherent oscillator. See, this coherent oscillator, that is generating frequency FC, that is IF frequency, intermediate frequency. See, this intermediate frequency, that we use it to increase input frequency of receiver. The reason is, if you increase input frequency of receiver, then you will be reducing flicker noise. See, flicker noise, one should know, flicker noise of receiver circuit, that is directly proportional to 1 divided by input frequency to the power alpha, where alpha is 1. So here flicker noise is inversely proportional to input frequency, that you can say. If input frequency is lower, then flicker noise will be higher. So what we do is, by using intermediate frequency with the use of coherent oscillator, we can increase input frequency of receiver over here. And as we increase input frequency over here, we will be having lower flicker noise, right? Now, if you observe, see, in this receiver, here we have mixer that is having two input signals. One is received echo signal and second is stable local oscillator frequency. So FL, that is second input. So we have two frequencies, FL plus FC plus or minus FD, and over here we have FL. So this mixer that is subtracting these two frequency means we are eliminating FL over here. So here we have frequency that is FC plus or minus FD, and this is what my input frequency. So input frequency is FC plus or minus FD. So now, because of FC, now input frequency of this receiver is higher, so flicker noise will be lower. Now, as FC is intermediate frequency, we are using IF amplifier over here. After that, we give it to phase detector. So FC plus or minus FD, that we give it to phase detector, and second input is FC over here. So that is eliminating FC, and output of this phase detector, that is plus or minus FD. And that signal that we give it to delay line canceller. Delay line canceller, that we use it to identify echoes of moving objects only. See, basically there will be echoes from stationary as well as moving objects. With the use of delay line canceller, we can eliminate echoes from the stationary objects, right? In future coming videos, I'll be explaining you delay line canceller in great details. Right now, just consider this. We will be receiving echo from multiple objects. Few objects are stationary and few objects are in motion. So with the use of delay line canceller, we can eliminate echoes from stationary and we can identify moving objects, right? So last block, that is of delay line canceller. That is how MTI radar with power amplifier transmitter is functioning. Now I'll explain you MTI radar with power oscillator. See, in this block diagram, almost everything is similar. Only in transmitter, we use magnetron oscillator, right? Power oscillator that we use, and that is magnetron oscillator. See, here there is an oscillator, means that is generating RF frequency over here, right? See, previously we were been having amplifier. So this amplifier, that was amplifying input signal, right? But now we have oscillator that is generating high power signal with RF frequency, right? So here we have magnetron oscillator that is generating high power and RF frequency, and that is what we are generating as per pulsed modulation, right? So here we have short duration of pulse that is getting modulated over here at output side. So we'll be having pulse over here, and during pulse there will be RF frequency generated by magnetron oscillator, and that is having frequency f of t, right? And that is what we give it to duplexer. Other things are same. Now in the receiver, now you see with the receiver exciter, we are taking partial signal from this magnetron oscillator to this mixture, and that we use it for RF locking pulse. So here we have RF signal that we give it to this mixture for RF locking. After that, we are connecting this mixture with stylo, and here we are generating IF locking pulse, and this IF locking pulse that is given to coho. So coho is detecting phase over here, and at last over here we will be having delay line canceller that is having signal with plus or minus FD, which is used to identify objects which are there in motion, right? So everything is similar as we have seen it with MTI radar with power amplifier. Only thing that you need to understand is, here we are using magnetron oscillator So it is generating high power RF signal pulse with the use of pulse modulation, and this partial signal, now that we give it to receiver exciter, that is for RF locking pulse. After that, mixer is generating IF locking pulse. So here we are locking IF frequency over here at this phase detector, and as if you lock it over here, then you can generate this signal that is having plus or minus FD, right? So this is how entire circuit is functioning. I hope you have understood all those basics, and if you want my notes and everything, then you can access it from my Android application engineering Funda. Still, if anything I would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.